Hey creative people, so it's October and you are painting some pumpkins here. So please subscribe, share and like, and I hope you'll enjoy it. Okay, so I have my toned canvas. This is black and purple. It's 30 by 20 centimeters. This is canvas board. I drew my pumpkins there, and I'm going to first block in my candle and pumpkins with filbert brush. Let's go through the palette. I'm going to be using titanium white. This is medium yellow, yellow ochre, magenta, orange, unbleached titanium, ultramarine blue, black and purple. So I'll start with filbert. This is number 12. I hope it won't be too big. Taking the unbleached titanium, a little bit of that orange. This orange is a opaque color, so I'm gonna. Okay, I'm starting here. Just to cover that background. I'm just now blocking in. Not worry here about perfect color or anything like that. Just cover that black. I'm not adding water there because that's this part is disappearing into the black and we won't be able to see that. So I'm using my stiff round brush to fade it a little bit. Maybe I should use smaller brush, but I'm thinking this is just first layer. Quickly cover that. This part is already disappearing into the completely black. I'm able to see this part here. And this whole part is black. This. These are not pumpkins. This is kind of, I don't know, some orange fruit. My brush, just to soften this part here. Okay, good. Black. Yellow ochre with this black. Just black. Let's pull it a little bit there. Tin layer. Brush. And that's it. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna... take my angle brush. Unbleached. Just covering that candle. Take a little bit orange. With water. Take and bleach a little bit yellow ochre. Bleach. This, take this orange a little bit blue. And bleach the black. I'm gonna a little bit of this color. Good thing here that you don't have to be so precise, because these are all organic things and they are not perfect. Okay. Okay. Gonna take a little bit more black. A little bit more water to improve the flow. Okay. this part here. This dry completely. If they dry, I'm gonna mix now. Using smaller film brush. Mixing first magenta and yellow. I think it's pretty similar to this orange, so I'm gonna use that orange. Too hard. My brush. Unbleached titanium, yellow ochre. Sitting here. Glaze over this, and I'm gonna make Magenta. Just mix the orange and magenta. Can we take that purple? So I'm using just pure purple here. Tint it with water. Layers now. Always can add more. And make much more depth into the painting if we use more layers. Acrylics are all about layers. More purple. Oh, it's transparent color and it's perfect for glazing. Okay, so let's add another glaze. So I'm gonna take a little bit of magenta. A little bit of black. Every glaze will have another mention of that and painting, because we are using transparent colors. Mix a bit magenta and yellow, so not ochre, then that medium yellow. I'm gonna add more magenta to this color. Just to try a little bit in the meantime. I added brown on my palette. It's really not can use raw umber or burnt umber. Any brown you like. Just gonna go over this here, actually a little bit here. Same thing. lot of water, a little bit paint, just thin coat of glaze over that. See how can we still see through this color, because it's transparent, and I can even add a little bit of that brown there. And maybe here. Take my orange with bleach and clean this line here. Down. But yeah. I'm using angle brush. Easier to manipulate with this because I need that clean line. Okay. Add titanium white to this yellow. I'm dry brushing here because we have that texture of the pumpkin. Okay. A little bit magenta to make that orangey color. Dark, so I'm gonna mix that blue and orange. Darker. And a little bit black to this color. I'm gonna add some dark. This one should go there, but yeah, it's okay, too late now. Let's increase that contrast. Yellow. This is pure yellow. Let's take unbleached titanium with a little bit of titanium white. I'm gonna mix those two colors. Okay, take more unbleached and touch of the yellow ochre. More yellow ochre. Of orange, just a touch. Magenta and black. Maybe it's better to use flat brush here. Sparkles there. Magenta and black, thin layer. Just remember that this previous layer needs to be completely dry, otherwise you can lift this previous layer. sensitive drum brush. Orange, a little bit blue, and titanium white. Okay. Unbleached. Gently don't do this. Clean brush. Try to stay in your lines. Don't rush. I really rushed this. And I don't know why. More unbleach and this part here. Not dry, so I'm gonna take my liner brush and black. Orange and unbleached just here on the top. And before we do the flame or the candle, this all needs to be completely dry. It's really important because if I do flame now, I'm gonna pick those previous layers and lift off that, and I don't wanna do that. So let's do Okay, so this is completely dry. Now I'm gonna take white with a dry brush. This is Filbert brush, and I'm gonna clean most of the paint. It's better if you have for this transparent white. Don't have that because it's not available in my country, but this dry. Meantime, I'm gonna take Unbleached Titanium. This needs to be lightest part of painting. So Unbleached Titanium, tapping some spots of light there. Unbleached Titanium, a little bit yellow. Light touch, I'm barely touching the canvas. Darker colors. Yeah. A bit magenta. Mix this all together. Yellow, a little bit yellow with this white. A little bit brown. Brown and unbleached titanium. Let's take a little bit white and yellow. Spots there. They're catching that light. Here. Magenta and black. Take pretty dark here. Thank you. orangey color here as a reflection from this pumpkin here. I like it. Orange. Let's increase saturation a little bit. Important. Take the round brush, the titanium white, just a hint. I don't know if you even can see that of yellow. Okay, think I'm done. I hope you like it. If you do, please subscribe, share, and like, and thank you for watching.